Hey everyone, I have an issue. Many issues, in fact. But in this case, it's a tech issue. There are two switches here, and they might look innocuous enough. The bottom one just controls my TV equipment, and it works absolutely fine. I can turn it on and off with no issue. But this top switch can never be turned off, and that's because it powers my Eero router here, but also my network switch down here. Now, my network switch is connected to an internet cable that runs all across my backyard into my garage. And as a result, if I turn off this switch up here, whoops, then what happens is I instantly lose internet access in my backyard and my driveway and my garage. Two CCTV cameras also get knocked offline in the process. Luckily though, I built a simple software solution that anyone can run, and basically what happens is if a crucial network device gets knocked offline, they'll send me an email. It works really well, let's have a look how you do this. Before I discuss why I coded up my own solution, I firstly want to discuss some of the other options that I test out first. Essentially, we're looking for network monitoring software, and on Windows, the most popular option is probably PRTG. There's also Nagios, although that doesn't run natively on Windows, which I'll discuss a little later. PRTG is actually a set of infrastructure monitoring tools, although we're mainly interested in their network monitor here. The website shows that it has lots of features, including the ability to generate lots of pretty graphs, and more crucially, it has automatic network discovery. What that means in practice is that PRTG can scan your entire local network, for example, and see exactly what devices are connected. It can then automatically create notification alerts, which they call sensors, so that you can get notified when certain network devices go offline. That's pretty much perfect for what I'm looking to do, and while PRTG is mainly a paid-for tool, their free tier supports up to 100 sensors, which would have been fine for me too. So why did I decide against PRTG? Well, it kind of boils down to me being a fairly pragmatic, keep it simple type person who doesn't like overly complex tools. PRTG is clearly a great software tool, especially for professional companies, but I don't really need this level of features just to get notified that a couple of my CCTV cameras have gone offline. I also found that despite scanning my local network for many minutes, PRTG only found a handful of network devices. Even if it was struggling to scan devices on a different subnet, in other words, those supplied by my other Eero devices, my desktop PC connects to the same switch as an IoT hub and a PoE switch that ultimately powers four CCTV security cameras. So the software should have picked these up at the very least, in my opinion. I did try manually adding one of these devices on a different subnet, which was my garage power Ethernet camera, but it kept complaining that it couldn't see or create sensors for it, which was a bit odd. Now, this is clearly something that I'm doing wrong because PRTG is a well-known bit of software, but it doesn't generally seem like the right fit for me. I get the feeling that I would have spent more time configuring and maintaining PRTG than anything else, to be honest. Since I have an Eero mesh Wi-Fi system, the next thing I explored was whether Eero has an API or not. After all, if they have a simple API, then I could just regularly use this to query which network devices are connected, and if a required device goes offline, I can then send an alert out. While Eero doesn't seem to have a well-established open API, 343 Max on GitHub has created an unofficial API for Eero that provides everything that I needed, such as devices connected to my network. Great! So I started to explore this option, and my initial tests worked quite well on the computer. The first time you run the script, it authenticates you by firstly asking for some login information and then asking for a two-factor auth code that was sent to my email. After this is complete, I can then run the script again and see all my connected devices. Sweet! Unfortunately, you might have worked out the problem here. I want a simple, automated solution here, but this Eero client can't bypass Eero's actual login mechanisms, and so it needs to ask me for my two-factor auth token, for example. This means that I either weaken my Eero account security by trying to disable two-factor auth, or I keep it, but then I can't easily use this Eero API automatically. You might be thinking, big deal, just log into your email within your script, but this adds an extra layer of complexity, and this starts getting a bit over the top for my use case, in my opinion. So it's frustrating because this is a useful tool, but I went back to the drawing board. I then scoped out a few other alternatives to PRTG, and there are quite a few, including Nagios, Domots, Sabix, and Emco. I'm not sure if I pronounced all of those correctly. Some of those are paid-for solutions, while some have a free tier. Emco looked particularly good to me because it looks fairly easy to set up and is not purely marketed as an enterprise software solution. I was an enterprise software developer for over a decade, and the word enterprise software still sends a shiver down my spine. However, at this point I started to wonder whether it would just be simpler to code my own solution. I didn't want to fall into the trap of spending loads of time configuring some fancy monitoring solution, all for a couple of CCTV cameras. You know, I'm not trying to monitor hundreds of mission-critical distributed servers for a Fortune 500 company. So I thought back to my legal hacking days and I remembered NMAP, the Swiss Army knife of networking. NMAP has loads of different functions, but it's particularly good at scanning over an IP or range of IPs and seeing whether any of these IPs has open ports. You can then use this knowledge for nothing. Nothing at all. The awesome thing with NMAP is you can give it a local IP range, and within seconds or minutes, it'll return any IP addresses which appear to be online. Now, it's never quite as easy as saying, yes, this IP address is online, because some IPs won't actually respond to pings, and others won't show any TCP ports, because they are hosting UDP services instead. However, in general, NMAP can still be a great tool, so I wanted to go down this route. I had a few options open to me then. I could code my own shell script, which calls NMAP natively and then sends an email if required, although this could get fairly clunky fairly quickly. Another option would be to use Node-RED, which is a JavaScript-based visual development tool that allows you to visually hook together different bits of code and scripts, essentially. So I could have installed Node-RED and added an inject mode to run an NMAP script, which then returns which local devices are online. Or I could have used a ping node or similar to ping an IP every so often, such as once a minute. You then have a function node to check if this returns false, and then add an email node, for example, to send you an email if it's offline. This solution would work really well, and there's no real flaws with it, other than the fact that I'm personally more comfortable with writing scripts in Python or a similar language, so that's the route that I went down. So I got started with writing some Python to ping a range of IP addresses and then cross-reference this results with a few IP addresses that must be online. In other words, the ones that would get knocked offline if someone turns the wrong switch off in your living room. I've put this script on GitHub, so I'll put a link down to that in the description too. But essentially, this is a Python 3-based script with minimal dependencies. It mainly expects that NMAP is installed on your system. I also use MailerSend to actually send out the notification emails, but you could swap this out with a custom version if you preferred. I won't go into too much detail on the script here, especially because the code is actually fairly self-explanatory and the README goes into lots of detail on how to get this script configured, set up, and running. But essentially, the script uses a Python NMAP wrapper to run a basic ARP discovery check over a range of IP addresses that you specify in the config.ini file. This will then give you a list of any active IP addresses, meaning that I can then work out whether any of the required IP addresses are missing. If so, this is a cause for concern, of course. However, I did notice that sometimes the NMAP ARP check actually missed out certain addresses. In other words, it was saying that certain IPs were offline, even when they weren't. So I added a quick fail-safe check that actually pings the required IP addresses one final time, just to check that they really are offline or not. Any results will then be sent out over email. In this case, I'm using MailerSend API to send out the email because it was much easier than actually worrying about configuring local email servers and worrying about deliverability rules. It's also free unless you're sending thousands of emails. You can create an account for free, and then you just need to add the domain you're planning to actually send email to, which was tristanperry.com in my case. MailerSend then gives you certain DNS records that you'll need to change to actually validate this domain for anti-spam purposes. If you have any doubts at all on this point, though, just contact your host or domain name registrar, and they should be able to help you out with changing the records. Once the domain is validated, you're pretty much good to go. The final thing to do is actually get a MailerSend API key, and this is then specified as a command line option when running the script. But this is because it's not really ideal to save this in a config file. You then just need to tweak the IP addresses in the config.ini file. If you only have a single router and all your devices are on 192.168.1, for example, then you can just put a single IP range here. But if you have a mesh Wi-Fi system, look through some of your connected devices in the router's admin panel or the app to see all of the IP subnet ranges your devices connect to. List these in the IP ranges to scan field. And finally, specify any mandatory Wi-Fi fields under the required IPs field. It helps if you assign these devices as static IPs within your router's admin panel or app, because otherwise the IP can change if the device restarts and then your script won't work correctly. Phew, that sounds like a lot of information, sorry. It's actually quite a straightforward script, but I wanted to cover everything that you need to know. You can then run the script in the usual way, either as a one-off command line option or by scheduling it into your system's crontab or whatever. If one of your crucial devices then goes offline, you'll receive an email. Nice. It's really that simple. Unless you struggle to get this script running, of course, in which case, please drop me a comment here or on GitHub and I'll see if I can make the instructions clearer. The final thing I wanted to point out is that I developed and ran this script on Ubuntu because that's what I prefer to develop in, but this should run fine on Windows 2 because I used cross-compatible code and wrappers. Just make sure that NMAP is actually available on the path when running the Python script. And that wraps up this video. I covered a lot of ground, so if you have any questions at all, please let me know down in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.